In this video, we're going to be looking at separable equations. dy dx is equal to x squared on y. And in this case, we can move the y over here, dy, and x squared dx. We're able to separate out the variables in such a way that we can associate the differential of the variable accordingly, according to the proper differential. So we have the differential dx, we can just cross multiply, and it's just simple algebra, and we end up with x squared dx and y dy, and we can quickly solve these. These are very simple integrals. Oops. Squared dx, and we can y squared equals 1 on 3 x to the third plus c. And multiplying across, we have y squared equals 2/3. Whoops, my hand's not working well this morning. Plus c. And y equals plus or minus 2/3 x to the third plus c to the 1/2 power. And that's our differential. And our solution. And they ask, where is this defined? Where is y of x defined? Well, for the differential, dy dx, we can't have y equals 0. And we're defined everywhere else. In this case, we can't have 2/3 x to the third plus c be negative. So that we can't have. Has to be a positive answer inside the argument of the square root. And we can have a negative value, especially with a cube root in the within the argument of the square root. So that's our solution for the first differential equation. Now let's take a look at the second one. We got quite a few to go through, so I'm just going to work them through. And here's our second example. We have dy dx is equal to x squared on y to 1 plus x to the third. And if you notice, only certain types of equations can apply. And in this case here, we have y dy equals x squared to the x over x cubed plus 1 dx. And now we can use a u substitution. U equals x to the third plus 1 du equals 3x squared dx. And so now we rewrite dy equals 1/3 du over u. And now we take the integral equals 1/3 ln of u plus c. And we integrate 1/2 y squared equals, well, I already integrated, darn it. This is the, let's make this right. Put the integral sign there. And that's what we have. And I put it in solve form. I'm sorry I didn't. In my mind, I just skipped the step. So we have 1/2 y squared, 1/3 ln of u plus c, and y squared equals 2/3 ln u is x cubed plus 1 plus c, and we have y of x equals, now we have ln x cubed plus 1 to the 2/3 plus c all to the 1/2 plus or minus. Now, we have to be careful here, because we can't have x cubed plus 1 equals or less than 0. Can't have a negative argument for the natural log. And in this case here, we can't have y equals 0 or 1 plus x cubed equals 0, or x cubed equals minus 1. So now we have our function, the solution to the differential equation. And you can see how we were able to separate the variables such that we could associate the variable with its differential. And we go on to the next one. These really are more of an exercise or a refresher on methods of integration, to tell you the truth. Dy, because these are differential equations that we don't have y squared sine of x, where we well, I mean in a way we do. I mean, we were looking at forms like y prime plus p of x, y equals g of x y to the n. And this does fit that form, but it's more like the kind of integrals that we solved previously. These are the simplest form of differential equation. So in this case, we have y to the negative 2 dy equals negative sine x dx. And now we have minus y to the minus 1. Oh, I'm jumping. Why should I jump? I should write it out. We're integrating y to the minus 2 dy. I guess I've been doing so many of these lately that I'm jumping a step. Minus sine x dx. And if you remember, if we had y equals cosine x, dy equals minus sine x dx. And if we integrate then we have cosine of x equals minus sine x dx. So we have minus y to the minus 1 equals cosine of x plus c. And this is 1 over y. 1 over y equals minus 1 over cosine of x plus c. No matter what we do to the constant is still undetermined no matter what we do to it. So it's only determined when we're given an initial condition. And we've not been given any initial conditions. So we really can leave that unchanged. This, however, I'm sorry. This is really y. And that is minus 1 over cosine, which is the secant of x plus c. And that is our solution. And we can't have x equal to pi on 2 or any multiple of pi on 2. So, for example, if we had this is pi on 2, this is 3 pi on 2, this would be 2 pi on 2, and this would be 4 pi on 2. So we have to say that x cannot be equal to pi on 2 times 2n plus 1. Any odd where if n is 0, then we have pi on 2. N is 0. If n is 1, then we have 3 pi on 2. If n is 2, then we have 5 pi on 2. And that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That would bring us back up here again. So you can see how this relationship holds. So this is defined everywhere except when x is equal to pi on 2 times 2n plus 1. And in this case, it's the same thing. X cannot be n pi, where n is an integer. Couldn't get my third dot in. Okay, so we can see that the realms in the xy plane where these are defined differ from the differential to the answer. So we got that one where, yeah, this is the, just want to make clear, this is our solution. Now we're going to try and get through these as quickly as possible. Here we are given, here's an interesting one. Y prime equals 1 plus x plus y squared plus x y squared. So, what do we do here? Well, let's say, for one thing, dy dx is defined everywhere. So, we don't have any constraints on that particular equation. Now, we can separate this, and we'll have to do a little algebra to do that. So we have 1 plus x plus 1 plus x times y square. And we can do further factoring by going 1 plus x times 1 plus y squared. Now we have a product. And this product is separable. We end up with dy over 1 plus y squared equals 1 plus x dx. And if we say, What can we say? We have to use a trig substitution for the bottom. So let's say y equals tangent theta, dy equals secant squared theta d theta, And we also notice that 1 plus y squared is equal to 1 plus tangent squared, which is equal to secant squared theta. So we have, in this case, secant squared theta d theta over secant squared theta, and this is x plus 1 dx, and we see the secants cancel out, and we have d theta equals x plus 1 dx, and this is theta equals, now we have 1 half x squared plus x, and we have a constant. So now we have to go back to the original variable where arctan of theta, of y is equal to theta. So we have arctan of y is equal to 1 half x squared plus x plus c. Now, where, what is, I think we're okay on this. We're defined everywhere. And we're the same with this one. So now, on to the next. Try to make this as expedited as possible because we have quite a few. Oh, yeah. They were talking something I kind of skipped over a bit, but we have something that was presented to us called the fundamental uniqueness and existence theorem. And that is saying that if f of x, y are continuous in some plane x, y, that's basically the x, y plane, where x is defined in some interval, let's say alpha to beta, and y is defined in some interval delta to phi, then in some interval where x is less than x naught plus h and greater than x naught minus h, so you have some x naught, y naught point within that area of the plane, there is a unique solution to y prime equals f of x y with y of x zero equals y zero. So it's saying that if the function f of x y is continuous within a specifically defined area in the xy plane, and your initial condition also exists within that plane, then you have a unique solution for the differential equation y prime equals f of x y. So that's what they call the uniqueness in existence theorem. Not only does there exist a solution, but there exists a unique solution satisfying this condition if x0 and y0 lie within the plane of continuity where the function is continuous. Okay, so that's one of the reasons why they're interested in finding out where the function is defined, because that's where, if there may be places where the function breaks its continuity within the xy plane and the solution is no longer valid. That's why we've been looking at the where does this function exist, or where can't it exist. Here we have dy dx equal to cosine squared x times cosine squared 2y. Well, in this case, we can bring this over here. So we have dy on cosine squared of 2y, and that is cosine squared x dx. Now, the argument 2y, we got to deal with that. So let's look at u equals 2y. Du equals 2dy, dy is then equal to du on 2. So let's change this. We got 1 half du over cosine squared of u equals cosine squared x d dx. We're going to have to do a little trigonometric identity manipulation to make this integrable. First off, we recognize this is 1/2 secant squared u du, and this now cosine squared. Remember, we have the double angle formula, cosine of 2x is equal to cosine squared x minus sine squared x. And we can say this is 2 cosine squared x minus 1 cosine 2x, and then cosine 2x plus 1 on 2 equals cosine squared x. So now we put this in here, 1/2 cosine 1 plus cosine 2x dx. And again, we've got to do something with the argument. Let's say q equals 2x dq on 2 equals dx. So this is equal to 1/4 1 plus cosine q dq, 1/2 secant squared u du. Now, if we remember, let's write it over here. If y equals tangent x, dy equals secant squared x dx. So the integral of secant squared x dx is just the tangent of x. So here, if we take the integral, we have 1/2 times tangent u, and we have 1/4 dq, so that's 1/4 q plus 1/4 cosine q dq. And to integrate that, let's see, we have, let's say we had y equals sine x, dy equals cos x dx, and if we integrated, we have sine x equals cosine x dx. So now we have 1/2 tangent mu equals q on 4 plus 1/4, and this is sine of q plus c. And now we substitute back for the arguments. U was 2y, so we have 1/2 tangent 2y is equal to, q was 2x, so we have x on 2 plus 1/4 sine of 2x plus c. But remember, we have an identity. Now, I don't know, do we want to take it that far where sine of 2x equals 2 sine x cos x? I don't know. Do we want to? Does it help? It does behoove us to take a look at where this is defined, because we remember that we have sine of 2y over cosine of 2y, and that means that pi on 2, again 3 pi on 2, we can't have 2y equal to pi on 2 times 2n plus 1, or y cannot be equal to pi on 4 times 2n plus 1. So this is where we're excluded. We cannot, this is undefined in that region, but it's defined everywhere up here. And I think this is the answer that they leave it in. Just want to make sure this was number 5. And yes, that's right. Okay. So we got the answer correct. We could always multiply across by 4, which is what the book does. They multiply by 4, so we have 2 tangent 2y equals 2x plus sine of 2x plus c. And I guess we could, well, we'll leave it at that. We could apply this, but then it really is moot. All right, let's now move to the next one. Some of these get quite challenging. Given x dy dx is equal to 1 minus y squared to the 1/2 power. Well, right now we can't have 1 minus y squared less than 0. So 1 minus y squared has to be greater or equal to 0. And minus y squared has to be greater than or equal to negative 1. Y squared has to be greater than 1, or can't be, actually. Because if... Whoops, what am I doing? Let's look at this again. We don't want... Okay. All right, so we can't have that. This is problematic. So minus y squared can't be less than negative 1. Y squared, it's got to be less than one, because if we had something, let's say, if it's one, we got one minus one. If it's two, it's one minus four, so we have minus three, and we can't have that. So it has to be, y squared has to be less than one. All right, so enough for that. So y squared has to be less than 1. And let's see where we can solve this. Let's get dy on square root of 1 minus y squared equals 1 on x dx. Again, we use a trig substitution where y could be equal to sine theta dy is equal to cosine theta d theta. So let's have cosine theta d theta over 1 minus sine squared theta, and this is to the 1/2, and 1 on x dx, and I think we're ready to integrate, so we can integrate. This we know, 1 minus sine squared theta is equal to cosine squared theta, and the cosines cancel, so we end up with d theta equals, and this is just the natural log of x plus c, so we have theta equals ln x plus c. Now theta, we have arcsine. Oops. Guess we can write it like this. A sine of y equals theta. So theta is a sine of y equals ln x plus c. And if we take the sine of both sides, we end up with y of x equals the sine of the natural log of x plus c. And our condition then is it's defined everywhere. Oh, except x cannot be 0. Because we can't have the natural log of 0. And so that's our solution. I guess if we want to be technical about it, we can write it this way. Plus sine of C, but that's another C, and there, that's our, we could write it in this way and leave it like that. So sine of ln x plus C is the answer. dy dx equals x minus e to the negative x over y plus e to the y. This is easily separable. We have y plus e to the y dy equals x minus e to the minus x dx. And what do we have here? E to the y is 0. E to the y is defined everywhere. The inverse of it is never 0, so this is everywhere. And y, it doesn't matter what y is, so everywhere, we're defined everywhere, because this always exists. Y plus e to the y is never 0. And that would be the only condition that would be excluded, is if the denominator could be 0. So we're defined everywhere on this one. So we don't have a case where the denominator could ever be 0. So let's go forward and solve it. So we have y dy plus e to the y dy equals x dx minus e to the minus x dx. And so, if we had y equals e to the minus x, dy equals minus e to the minus x dx, and if we integrated, we have e to the minus x equals e to the minus x dx, and that's what we have. So we have 1 half x squared plus e to the minus x plus c. Here we have 1 half y squared plus e to the y. So, how do we simplify? We got y squared plus 2 e to the y equals x squared plus 2 e to the minus x plus c. And that is it. And this function is defined everywhere. We have dy dx, dy dx is equal to x squared over 1 plus y squared. Now we separate it and we have 1 plus y squared dy equals x squared dx. This is defined everywhere because the denominator is never zero. And now all we have to do is integrate, and we have y plus 1/3 y cubed equals 1/3 x cubed plus c. This is defined everywhere. I guess we could multiply through by 3. So we have y cubed plus 3y minus x cubed equals c. And that's it. Okay, so we're going to start looking at problems with initial conditions. And we've got this problem, sine of 2x dx plus cosine of 3y dy equals 0, with y of pi on 2 on 2 equals pi on 3. Now this one's going to be really intensive in trigonometric identities. So first off, let's get the arguments right. So let's say u equals 2x, du on 2 equals dx. Let's say q equals 3y, and dq on 3 equals dy. We have now 1/2 sine of u du plus 1/3 cosine q dq equals 0. If we integrate these, we end up with minus 1/2 cosine of u plus 1/3 sine of q equals c. All right. Make sure I got everything correct. We got to put in for u, 2x plus 1/3 sine 3y equals c. So that's our general solution. If we plug in pi on 2, for x and pi on 3 for y, we have minus 1 half cos pi plus 1 third sine pi equals c. But pi is negative 1, so we have 1 half, and sine of pi is 0, plus 0 equals c. So now we have 1 third sine of 3y is equal to 1 half cosine 2x plus 1 half. But if we recognize this, that's cosine 2x equals cosine squared x minus sine squared x. So cosine of 2x plus 1 on 2 equals cosine squared x. And that's what we have here. So we have sine of 3y equals 3 cosine squared x. And then if we take the arc sine, we have a sine of sine 3y equals a sine of 3 cosine squared x. And this is just 3y. And so y of x is equal to 1 third arc sine of 3 cosine squared x. And that's our answer. Just have to recognize our trigonometric identities. Now let's look at the next problem. This one is x dx plus y e to the minus x dy equals 0. Now, to make this separable, we just multiply through by e to the x. So we have x e to the x dx plus y dy equals 0, with the initial condition of y of 0 equals 1. Now to integrate, we have a simple integration in y, but the other one we have to do using uv substitution. So if u is, u is equal to x, du equals dx, v equals e to the x, dv equals e to the x dx. So we have u, v, so that's x e to the x equals e to the x dx plus x e to the x dx. So we have x minus 1 e to the x equals x e to the x dx. And we substitute that in up here. We have x minus 1 e to the x plus 1 half y squared equals c. So, moving things around, we have 1 half y squared equals 1 minus x e to the x plus c, and y squared equals 2, 1 minus x e to the x plus c, and y, let's see now, y of x is equal to the square root of that whole business. So we have 2, 1 minus x e to the x plus c raised to the 1 half. Now, the initial condition was y of 0 equals 1. So we have 1 equals 2 times 1, e to the 0 is 1, plus c, 1 half, and squaring it, we have 1 equals 2, plus c, so c equals minus 1. So we have y x is equal to 2 times 1 minus x e to the x minus 1 to the 1 half. And that should be the answer. Yeah, that's it. Okay. So now we move on to the next. Okay. So that's that one. Let's look at a simple one. We looked at this one. Here's a simple one. We got dr d theta equals r. And the initial condition is, what is the initial condition? R of 0 equals 2. So we have 1 on r dr equals d theta. So this, when we integrate, is the natural log of r equals theta plus c, and raising that to the by e, so we have r of theta equals e to the theta plus c equals e to the theta times e to the c, but that's also a c prime, So that's equal to C prime e to the theta r of theta, but r of 0 is equal to 2 is equal to C prime e to the 0. So C prime is 2, and r of theta is equal to 2 e to the theta. And that was a quick one, a simple one. dy dx is equal to 2x over y plus yx squared. And that is equal to 1 on y times 2x on x squared plus 1. So we have y dy equals 2x on x squared plus 1 dx. But here, if we have u equals x squared plus 1, du equals 2x dx. So we have du on u and we have y dy, so this is 1 half y squared when we integrate, and that's equal to ln u plus c, and that's 1 half y squared equals ln x squared plus 1 plus c, and y squared equals 2 ln x squared plus 1 plus c, and y equals the square root of 2 ln x squared plus 1 plus c. And remember, this was, y of 0. Y of 0 equals negative 2. Okay, so remember this is a plus or minus at this point. Alright, so because a square root can never yield, if f of x is some x to the 1/2, we can never have x to the 1/2 equal a negative number, so that we have to choose the negative result. So if we have minus 2 equals minus 2 ln, and this is 1 plus c, and ln of 1 is 0, so we have 2 equals square root of c, which means c equals 4, and y of x equals minus 2 ln x squared plus 1 plus 4. raised to the 1/2. And this is a little tricky. It forces you to think a little as to which to choose, because when you have a y squared, you have two possible solutions. And in this case, you have to take the negative solution. Okay, so here we have 1 dy, dy dx is equal to xy to the third times 1 plus x squared 1/2. So we have y to the minus 3 dy equals x. Oh, this is a minus 1/2 x on 1 plus x squared 1/2 dx. So let's see what we have. We can do several different ways. We could do a trig substitution, or we could say u is equal to x squared plus 1 du equals 2x dx. Du on 2 equals x dx. So this then becomes u to the minus 1/2 du, and this is y to the minus 3 dy. And if we integrate, we've got, remember, we have x to the n dx is x to the n plus 1 on n plus 1. So here we have y to the minus 2 on minus 2 is equal to u to the 1/2 times 2 plus c. And so we have one over y squared equals minus 4 u x squared plus 1 to the 1/2 plus c. And the initial condition was y of 0 equals 1. But we need to, well, let's see if we can solve for c first. So y of 0 is 1, so 1 squared, that's 1, equals minus 4 times 1 to the 1/2 plus c. So this is 3, 5 equals c. So y squared equals 1 on 1 minus, let's see, minus 4 times x squared plus 1, 1/2, plus 5. Let's try this again. All right, so we have dy dx equals x y cubed 1 plus x squared to the negative 1/2. So this is y to the minus 3 dy equals x on one plus x squared to the 1/2 dx. If we choose u equals x squared plus 1, du is equal to 2x dx. So we have du on 2 equals x dx. So we have one half du on u to the 1/2. Where that's equal to 1/2 u to the minus 1/2 du, and this is y to the minus 3 dy. So in this case we would have minus 1/2 y to the minus 2 equals 1/2 mu to the minus 1/2 du, but that is equal to 2 u to the 1/2 times 2, so that's u to the minus 1/2. Okay, so uh, That would be equal to 2 on 2 mu to the 1/2 plus c. So y squared equals minus 2 times x squared plus 1 to the 1/2 plus c. Sort of y of 0 equals 1, so we have 1 equals minus 2 is that correct? Plus c, which would mean c equals 3. All right, so y squared, again, this is minus. And then y squared equals 3 minus 2 1 plus x squared to the minus 1/2. And that becomes y. And that is y of x. And that's our solution. You have to be careful with these initial value problems, because there's a high potential for screwing up the math. We could have solved that problem a number of ways. We could have used a trig substitution. In that case, I just used the u substitution. dy dx is equal to 2x on 1 plus 2y, and what's the initial condition? Y of 2 equals 0. So here we have 1 plus 2y dy equals 2x dx, and we have y plus y squared equals x squared plus c. So 2 times plus, what am I doing? Let's solve this first. We have y squared plus y minus x squared minus c equals 0. Using the quadratic formula, we have y of x equals plus or minus 1/2. Minus 1/2, what am I doing? Trying to rush through too quickly. Plus or minus 1/2 b squared 1 minus 4 times minus x squared minus c. And so we have y of 2 is 0. So we have 0 equals minus 1/2 1/2, 1 plus 4, C, and we end up with 1 equals 1 plus 4C, and is that correct? Let's see. Is that correct? Is that correct? Well, let's look. We do have that. Let's do that. That's 0 plus 0 equals 4 plus C. So C equals minus 4. And we have y squared plus y minus x squared plus 4 equals 0. And then we apply. We got y of x equals minus 1/2 plus minus 1/2, 1 minus 4x squared plus minus 4. What am I doing? X equals minus 1/2 plus minus 1/2, 1 minus 4 times negative x squared plus 4, and that is equal to 1/2 plus minus 1/2, 4x squared minus 15. And that's y of x. Now we have y squared dy equals x one minus x squared dx. So let's say x is equal to sine of theta. And we have dx equals cos theta d theta. So this then is theta on one minus sine squared theta d theta is equal to theta on cos theta d theta. Oh, but I forgot one thing. We got a cos theta d theta, so those cancel. We have 1/2 theta squared plus c, and this is 1/3 y to the third, and we're given an initial condition, I think. No, we're not. We're just given this. We're just given this equation. So we don't have an initial condition problem. Instead, we have y to the third equals 3/2 theta squared plus c, and y of x equals 3/2 theta squared plus c to the 1/3, and that's it. But remember, theta squared. So we have a sine of x equals theta. So y of x equals 3/2 a sine of x squared plus c 1/3, and that'll do it. Our next one, we're getting close. Here's an interesting problem. We got dy dx is equal to a x plus b and cx plus d. Well, this is easily separable because it's already separated. What we have to do is break this up. We got ax on cx plus d, and we have plus b on cx plus d, and this is dy dx dx. Now, in this case, we use u equals cx plus d, du equals cdx. Then dx is du on c So we have A on C, du on U, but we have an X up here, plus B on C, du on U. Now, what do we do with that X? Well, X is mu minus D on C. So we have A on C times U minus D on C, pull that out, U, D, U, plus B on C, D, U on U, so we have right here A C squared DU minus D on U D, whoops, yeah, DU plus B on C, D, U, on U. Okay, now we have this. When we integrate, we have Y of X equals A on U C squared minus D C squared ln U plus B on C ln U. But we can use rules of exponents to help us out here. So we have A U, whoops, but we know what U is. Let's, so we have A C squared, U is C C X plus D minus D on C squared, but that is, we can combine these here like this. All right, we can combine these by plus ln U mu to the B C on mu to the D on C squared, and that is equal to A on C X. Well, we have a constant. We don't want to forget about that. And this term, A C squared D, adds to the constant. So we just add that. So that's A on C X plus Okay, now, Lynn, we have B on C, but if we do that, and again, this is A there. I forgot the A. And so we have BC minus AD on C squared ln of U. So this is CX plus D plus C, and that's the answer. Or actually, we could call it K, but it doesn't matter. So Y on X, that's our general solution. We gotta bracket that. And that's our general solution for this problem. Four to go. This one's similar. This one, again, is dy dx is equal to a y plus b on cy plus d. And rearranging, we have CY plus D on AY plus B DY equals DX. And we use the same algebra of separating these. So we have C Y on A Y plus B plus D, or this is D Y plus D D Y on A Y plus B equals DX. We use U substitutions. So U equals AY plus B DU on A equals DY. And U minus B on A equals Y. So here we have C Y U minus B on A on U and the U on A is dy plus d on a du on u equals dx. That a doesn't look much like an a. So let's make it an a. This is C on A. times, oh, that could be a squared. So mu minus b on mu du plus d on a du on u equals dx. And a little more, c on a squared du minus b du on u plus d on a du on u equals dx. Now we integrate. And we have c on a squared du is u minus b ln u plus d on a ln u equals x. And now if we gather our terms together, we have C mu on a squared plus ln, whoops, we can skip a step because of the previous problem. We've got plus AD minus BC on A squared ln U plus C equals X. And we have C on A Y plus A D minus B C on A squared then A Y plus B plus K equals X of Y. Or the other way around. It's the same thing. We have X of Y equals C on A Y plus AD minus BC on A squared ln AY plus B plus K. And that's the solution. And this is our last one. This one's a little tricky. dy dx is equal to y minus 4x on x minus y. And what do? We make this separable by pulling out x. So if we went like this, we have y on x minus 4 on 1 minus y on x. And then substituting a variable, a new variable, equal y on x. So we have dy dx is equal to v minus 4 on 1 minus v. But what do we do with dy dx? Well, we have to look at what dy dx is going to be. So if we say d dx of v of x equals dy dx, we have dv dx times x plus v equals dy dx. So we substitute that in. We have x dv dx is equal to v minus 4 on 1 minus v. And that's equal to v squared minus 4 on 1 minus v. So now we can separate this equation. We have 1 minus v on v squared minus 4 dv equals 1 on x dx. So we pull this out. We have 1 on v squared minus 4 minus v on v squared minus 4 dv. But if we use a substitute for that, 1 on x dx, we have q equals x squared minus 4 dq equals 2x dx. So here we have 1, let's break this out, x plus 2 times x minus 2 minus 1/2 dq on q equals 1 on x dx. So we're getting there, we're getting into form, but we have a problem with this. So what do? We say a is a v plus 2 plus b on v minus 2 is equal to 1 on v squared minus 4. Multiplying through, we get v minus 2 plus b v plus 2 equals 1. Now we just solve for a and b, and if v equals 2, we have b equals 1/4. And if v equals 0, we have negative 2a plus 1/4 times 2 equals 1. So that's a equals minus 1/4. So now we have two integrals. We got dv So we have minus 1/4 on V plus 2 plus 1/4 dV plus 1/4 dV on V minus 2 minus 1/2 dQ on Q equals 1 on X dx. And if we know our integrations, which we should by this point, we have minus 1/4 ln V plus 2 plus 1/4 ln V minus 2 minus 1/2 ln Q, but Q is X, V we gotta make that right. V squared to V. So that's V squared minus 4. And that is ln X. And we have some constant there. And if we multiply through by 4, we have ln minus ln V plus 2 plus ln V minus 2 minus 2 ln V squared minus 4 equals 4 ln X plus the constant. Now we're out of room. We've got to get a new screen. So let's try and remember this. We'll write it down. We got minus ln V plus 2 plus ln V minus 2 minus 2 ln V squared minus 4 equals 4 ln X plus C. And V was equal to Y on X. So, oops, what am I doing? We gotta get a clean sheet. Okay. So we have minus ln V plus 2 plus ln V minus 2 minus 2 ln V squared minus 4. And minus ln 4 ln X equals a constant. Now, if we raised everything to the e, the power, this is still a constant. A different kind, but that's K. So we have Well, what we should do is combine everything first using exponent, the laws of logarithms. So we have, let's expand this out a little bit, minus ln v plus 2 plus ln v minus 2 minus 2 ln, and we have v plus 2 times v minus 2 minus 4 ln x. And we can expand this out further. We got minus ln v plus 2 plus ln v minus 2 minus 2 ln v plus 2 plus ln v minus 2 minus 4 ln x equals k. So now we can do a little bit of paring down. Here we have minus 3 ln v plus 2 plus, okay, we have ln v minus 2 minus 2, so that is a minus sign. Okay, so that's going to be plus ln v minus, minus 2 plus 2 ln v minus 2 minus 4 ln x equals k. We got a mistake here. That's a minus. This is a minus. And so that leaves us with minus 3 ln times v plus 2 minus 1 ln v minus 2 minus ln x to the fourth equals k. And if we multiply through by negative 1, we have 3 ln v plus 2 plus ln v minus 2 plus ln x to the fourth equals k again. And now we can further combine. We have, and remember, v equals y on x. So let's do something here. we got 3 ln y on x, so this is y plus 2x on 1 on x. This is y minus 2x on 1 on x. And this is ln x to the 4th equals k. Now we can raise everything to their proper powers. We got ln, and let's bring them together. We've got y plus 2x to the 3rd times 1x to the 3rd times 1 on x times y minus 2x times x to the 4th. So it's all combined together. And here we end up canceling all the x's, and we have ln y plus 2x to the 3rd times y minus 2x equals k, raise that to the power e, and we have y plus 2x to the 3rd times y minus 2x is equal to some constant k prime. And that's our answer. It's going to be some, no matter what you do to that constant, no matter, it's going to be a constant anyway, so equals c. And that's the answer. A lot of bookkeeping with this problem, really. So, even though the answer's simple, getting there wasn't so simple. Okay, and that'll be it for the time being. We got some more coming up in differential equations. There's a lot of material, so we'll be going through all this stuff. Homogeneous equations, and then second order. And we'll even try some numerical methods. So we got a number of things to do. So, this is just the beginning of differential equations.